to lock you. Little gust of wind came through, took the camera out. Now we back up in it. Come on with it. All right. Go ahead, you can read that. Man, this shit is crazy. I'm gonna have to babysit it for a second.
This is Sirach 31 and 26. The furnace proveth the edge by dipping, so doth wine in the hearts of the proud by drunkenness. Wine is a good as life to a man if it be drunk moderately. What life is it then to a man that is without wine?
If it's drunk moderately, that means there's nothing wrong with drinking. But you got people, they got to drink every day. You know what I mean?
Get up in the morning, drink.
Fuck that. Hey, I don't know how to even do it. I feel like shit if I drank every day.
Take a shit. For it was made to make man glad. Wine measurably drunk and in season bringeth gladness of the heart and cheerfulness of the mind. The wine drunken with excess maketh bitterness of the mind with brawling and quarreling. Drunkenness increases the rage of a fool. To offend, it diminishes strength and maketh wounds.
Yeah, that's why you gotta control it, man. Moderation, just enough to get you feeling good and relaxed. You know, not enough to get. Hey, I've been to the point you drink so much liquor, man.
You can't stop.
You know, next thing you know, you're running from the cops. Man.
Oh shit!
I've been there before.
Well, you've been having them nights too, where you just keep drinking it, and they don't do nothing to you, just chugging it.
Yeah, right. The spirit ain't dealing with you. The spirit is totally ignoring you.
I ain't gonna lie, cause I don't drink. I drink maybe like once a week, if that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But sometimes when I start drinking that wine, boy, I start going down like Kool-Aid. I can't stop. Did I? Oh shit.
Like, I'm about to kill this motherfucker.
Hey, man.
Nigga was fucked up.
I apologize.
Drinking liquor, beer, wine. You remember we was killing those snacks, weren't we?
So I don't even remember that part.
All those snacks was all over the side of the toilet.
Oh, man.
Oh my God.
Hey, bro, that's why you can't be drinking like that.
All right, man, I don't know.
You gotta learn from your. I didn't even realize that happened.
Man, hey, man, you was at my house, though. You weren't out in the world. You
was
at my house. All right. 5 West Fifth Avenue.
I had a lot.
I threw up in people's in cars before, you know. I threw up in a motherfucker's my car, too.
Hey, bro. I had a stressful day. Had a stressful life.
Right.
Everybody got a story. Hey, the worst one I ever had, bro, was drinking that Wild Irish Rose. Now, that shit almost killed me. Man, I drank 2 whole bottles of the big ones once. I was talking about the big ones. I drank 2 of them. I thought I was in the spiritual world. That shit is not safe.
That's why they give it to us.
Yeah.
That's why
they
give it to us.
Yeah, you ain't supposed to be drinking that shit.
They give it to us cheap, too. That's some cheap shit. Anybody can afford it.
Smell like rum and alcohol.
Rum and alcohol mixed with transmission fluid. Like you see transmission fluid, it's color. It's red.
Oh, yeah,
you know?
It does. That looks like transmission fluid. That's
people stressed and oppressed, so they
gotta
drink
have
anything,
it. They drink anything.
I don't blame them, man. I don't blame them. They gotta realize that you can't rely on them drinks, man. You gotta come into the Lord's fold. You finished with that, bro? Oh, you got more? Okay. Hey, your girl ain't coming out here that got her Bible, man. She says she's coming where her book next week.
Man, you know she was full. She was lying.
Holy shit.
She done totally forgot about that.
It's like drunk right now. Money
should make. Sirach 31 and 31. Rebuke not thy neighbor at the wine, and despise him not in his mirth. Give him no despiteful word, and press not upon him when he heard his drink.
Yeah, cause some people don't need to be drinking.
I understand you curse out a wicked motherfucker, but you ain't that filthy no more that anybody and everybody.
Yeah. Hey, we don't get like that.
That's like a loud bro. That's like a, you know, like these women. You know, a woman don't give a shit anyway. Now, give a woman some alcohol. Men, hey, what formula is that? You know, a crazy woman with alcohol. She's stirring up everybody around. Everybody.
I'll harass you.
You know, you got more of that? Here you go. Well, I don't know if you ever need this one. This is just how, you know, scripture, how we can drink. Deuteronomy 14 to 26. And thou shalt bestow that money for whatsoever thy soul lusteth after, for oxen, or for sheep, or for wine, or for strong drink, or for whatsoever thy soul desire. And thou shalt eat there before the Lord thy God, and thou shalt rejoice thou in thine household.
Yeah, so.
Something that you gotta do in moderation.
Wait, yeah, in moderation. I mean, they called the Lord a wine bibber in Matthew 11, so he was drinking.
So what's wrong with drinking?
Proverbs 31:1. The words of King Lemuel, the prophecy that his mother taught him. What, my son, and what the son of my womb, and what the son of my vows. So this was what a woman taught her son. Give not thy strength unto women, nor thy ways to which destroyeth kings. Like, yeah, you ain't supposed to let a woman be in charge of nothing. You ain't supposed to let her be in charge of your finances, your money. You ain't supposed to trust her with your secrets, and, you know, and whatever. You don't tell her nothing, you know what I'm saying? Because she gonna tell everybody your business. You tell your woman something you don't want nobody to know, it, now everybody's gonna know.
Finances.
Yeah, fine.
Your personal bedroom business.
You don't tell her nothing.
Yeah.
Okay.
You gotta actually instruct her. Don't tell her business. You gotta keep instructing because she forgets, you know? They just like talking. They just like gossiping.
Yeah. Let me get the rest of this. It is not for kings, O Lemuel. It is not for kings to drink wine, nor for princes strong drink. Lest they drink and forget the law, and pervert the judgment of the afflicted. Right? Or pervert the judgment of any of the afflicted. Yeah, because like he was just talking earlier. Some people, they get on they start boozing. And, you know, like he said, it takes that filter off. Pretty much turns them into an asshole. But here's the scripture right here. Proverbs 31:6. Give strong drink unto him that is ready to perish, and wine unto those that be of heavy hearts. Let him drink and forget his poverty, and remember his misery no more. That's what these winos do out here. They just be boozing it up because they want to forget the, you know, this filter they living in.
It's a temporary escape.
Yep.
You know, temporary escape. This hell coming back in this motherfucker when the spirit gets back on you, back into this motherfucker.
And you did that.
You gotta get another.
They gotta get another one. That's what our wild eyes come in. That's the only thing they can afford.
Yeah, they on the corner at the end of the freeway begging for change and shit. And that's what they doing, man. Same motherfucker on the same corner. Each corner do that. Put their hand out. Or with a sign, I get some change. I'm hungry. No, nigga, I'm thirsty. Y'all finish with that one?
A lot of times they found out you get more money if you're just honest. They be like, I need a drink, bro.
Yeah, I might drink with you.
Yeah, we might get it in. Until you start hitting them scriptures, and they be gone.
This is 1 Ezra 4:37-36. All the earth calls upon the truth, and the heavens bless it. All works shake and tremble at it, and with it is no unrighteous thing. Wine is wicked. The king is wicked. Women are wicked. All the children of men are wicked. And such are all their wicked works, and there is no truth in them. And their unrighteousness also they shall perish.
I see it, bro. She looked like, she reminded me of that Queen of Heaven idol you seen back there, the artifacts, the big old thick, and they got that gigantic breast.
Hitting it hard,
man. Then we still on wine and alcohol?
Yeah, Psalms 104, you start 14, but 20 is 15. He causes the grass to grow for the cattle and the herb for the service of men, that he may bring forth food out of the earth, and wine that maketh glad the heart of man, and oil to make his face to shine, and bread which strengthens man's heart.
Hey, that's good, talking about the bread too, with the food, but now it's a long tradition of our forefathers is to drink that unleavened bread and drink that wine. That's why the Lord said that. Because you got a lot of these churches, they be like, you're not allowed to drink alcohol. You know they're liars, because they was drinking wine at the Last Supper, and the Lord said that the wine is his blood. That don't even make no sense. You know what I'm saying? Somebody tells you you're not allowed to drink, just go tell them to go fuck themselves. You know what I mean? Basically. That doesn't make any sense either. You can drink, but you can't get... It don't take for me with one little glass and I'm gone. You know what I mean? The first one's the worst one.
I'm 6 months sober.
I tell you, it's usually the first one to get you. You know what I mean? The first and the last one.
Sober, I go to AA
meetings. The Lord is not dealing with AA meetings.
You say all little songs, poems together.
Oh yeah, the founder of it, that Alcoholics Anonymous, Bill W. He's a Freemason. He's a Freemason.
There it is.
That's all you need to know.
What's a Freemason?
He's a warlock, a damn wizard. Right, right. That's why they use that triangle with the circle symbol, going back to ancient Egypt.
Did somebody read Ecclesiastes 19:1? A lazy man that is given to drunkenness shall not be rich, and he that committeth such things shall fall by little and little. Wine and women will make men of understanding to fall away, and he that cleaveth to harlots will become.
Did they what they say? He cleaned the harlots what?
Let me read again. Wine and women will make men of understanding fall away.
Oh yeah, because wine and women will make men of understanding fall away. So that's why a lot of dudes that come out here, they'll do the work with us, but then they care more about their woman and pleasing that woman more than they care about pleasing the Most High.
Yeah, the woman like to hit the clubs on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Yep. And she wants you to be with her, spending your money.
You know? And she don't want you be seen out there wearing these garments. Right, like you on a corner looking all raggedy.
Just raggedy garments.
Yeah.
And he that cleaveth to harlots will become impure. Moths and worms shall have him to inherit, and a bold man shall be taken away.
Oh, my fault. Yeah, but that's the thing. Because if you got a woman, a wife, why we just read that scripture proper? You supposed to be the man in the house. You tell her what to do. She don't tell you what to do. You know what I mean? You running shit. She ain't running nothing. Exactly. If you got a woman, she don't want to obey your commands, she's got to go. You know what I mean? What good is she? What good is a woman if she don't obey your commandments? Because a woman's supposed to call her husband Lord. Okay? So really, if your woman doesn't call you Lord, you don't have a good woman. How many women you know that call their husband Lord? As commanding, the Bible commands this.
I'm kind of curious now with the Rothschilds.
They probably do do it, don't they?
I'm kind of curious. I am kind of curious. They probably smart. They smart anyway. They keep their women good, actually.
You don't ever hear about them women.
Right. They ain't got nothing. They got a bunch of chickens locked up in a cage in Mexico.
I got that one scripture though. Ecclesiastes 10:19. A feast is made for laughter, a wine maketh merry, and money answereth all things. There you feel that gust coming. Now it's time to get on these hoes. through the ship. All these queens out here.
Our leaders. Our leaders.
It's feminazis. You guys want to read?
I got something else.
Go ahead.
This is Ecclesiastes 26:8. A drunken woman in a gabber abroad causes great anger, and she will not cover her own shame. The whoredoms of a woman may be known in her haughty looks and eyelids.
And that's all the women. That's all they do. They wake up in the morning, take an hour, put all their makeup on. Oh, not for you. They'll do that to go to work because you got a woman and she has a job. Oh, she's cheating on you. Believe that. She's having sex with somebody at her work. If you think otherwise, you're a fool. Because a woman's not supposed to be working at all, especially around other men. You know, the scriptures say sitting at it all with another man's wife. Okay, so all women are not supposed to be going out working. All women are not supposed to be around other men besides their husband. That's wicked as hell.
If thy daughter be shameless, keep her in scraping. If she abuse herself, overmuch liberty. Watch over and keep an eye.
Yeah, you gotta look. Because everybody's trying to get your woman or your daughter.
And marvel not if she trespass against thee. And this woman is just literally just fucked up and she fucked up.
Yeah, they get all bugged out and amazed that they could do such a thing.
You should have known, we told you that this woman on the creek.
Yep.
You know, what's the song, Secret Lovers?
Secret Lovers.
You know, Secret Lovers.
That's some wicked shit, man. And they make it sound beautiful too, the song.
That's what we are.
They hit a song about adultery. It sounds all pleasant and beautiful. It's a hit. They make millions off of it.
15 Grove City Local to Parkway Center.
By this old school sister back in the late 60s. She and her man broke up and she's putting out a help wanted ad, you know? Wanted a new nigga. Wanted.
That's evil as hell.
Young man, single man free. That's all bad too. Somebody experienced it. Watch over the prudent eye and marvel not if she trespass against thee. She will open her mouth as a thirsty traveler. What do they call niggas, brothers, man? They call us men. Y'all thirsty. Y'all thirsty. The scripture says they thirsty.
And the woman is thirsty.
She will open her mouth as a thirsty traveler when he has found a fountain and drink of every water near her.
That, what is that talking about? She's blowing everybody, drinking it. I mean, that's in the Bible. And it told you that these bitches out here fucking being nasty as hell.
Eventually, one of the niggas gonna cling to it. So she playing the number. I blow enough. Eventually, I'm gonna get her something. You know? And she's gonna get home. This is nasty, man. I was just reading about gonorrhea. How they catch gonorrhea in the throat, man. You know? And you can smell it.
And then they've got a certain spray they do so they can deep throat it better. They spray it.
A lot of them get their tonsils removed. You know? Get their tonsils removed so they won't gag, man. They say gag. By every hand when she sit down, they open her quiver against every arrow.
Again, she gonna open her quiver against every arrow.
4F.
It looks like a dick.
It is.
Look at the arrow. The dick and the arrow.
Yep, it does. Just like a missile, too. Yeah, these women ain't shit.
That's some crazy shit, man. These motherfuckers are glad to get some medication to cover this shit.
I got a scripture. Deuteronomy 23:17. There shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel, nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel. Thou shalt not bring to hire of a whore or the price of a dog, what's a female dog? Thou shalt not bring the hire of a whore or the price of a dog into the house of the Lord thy God for any vow, for even both of these are an abomination unto the Lord thy power. So the Lord said, you ain't supposed to let your daughters be whores and don't let your sons be faggots. That's a commandment.
Amen.
It's in the Bible.
Amen. That's right. And Ice-T and them niggas, they love this. They love, you know.
Oh,
they brag about their fame on Big Pimps, man. They brag about the money he still had made from doing that shit, man.
I just say they got somebody, they got a new body count out. That shit is nowhere as good as the old body count.
Yeah, the new body count.
Yeah.
Oh, actually, the new one's pretty decent. The one before that was garbage.
Oh, maybe that's the one I heard.
Yeah, this one probably before that was garbage. Here you go. This is like Leviticus 20:10. And the man that committeth adultery with another man's wife, even he that committeth adultery with his neighbor's wife, the adulterer and the adulteress shall surely be put to death.
They ain't upholding these laws in the court system, are they? The court system goes totally against the Bible. The Bible says adulterers get put to death. The courts reward the woman for committing adultery. She get child support. You know what I'm saying? She get EBT, Section 8. She get all these rewards and all these goodies for committing adultery. And then if the man don't pay child support, they'll lock him up. Check that out. Where else? Look at these damn muscles go. Now you think about it. If you got a woman with a bunch of children and she can't afford to pay for them, everybody feels sorry for her. She gets EBT, Section 8, all kind of goodies, right? But what if a man has a bunch of children and he can't afford to pay for them? What happens then? Oh, shit, he's a no-gooder. He gets locked up, pays child support.
He got to resort to robbing and selling drugs or whatever.
You know what I'm saying? That's wicked as hell. This wicked-ass country. That's why the Lord's going to destroy America with fire. That destruction's coming, bro.
And any help is very little help.
He get none. He get no help.
He's the family.
Oh, he's not a dead dad. He's a piece of shit. But if the woman can't afford to feed the kids, oh, she's a strong woman.
That bitch get weak.
That's hypocrisy at its finest. You know what I mean? That's beyond hypocrisy.
What stands for? Women, something, children.
Women.
Women, something, children. Weak. That's weak. They're weak when they get no
kids. Yeah, they get weak. They can give a man no whip. That's why these people gotta go, man. That's why, yeah, scripture too. That's the law in the Bible. So all these adulterers, hey, let's get that in Revelation. Because they're not off the hook. They gotta pay for those crimes. Especially if they don't repent, they gonna pay for their crimes. Go ahead.
If a man be found lying with a woman married to her husband, then they shall both of them die.
Die.
Both the man that lay with the woman and the woman, so shalt thou put evil from Israel.
So you
now
get
this law is on the woman. She's with you, you know, if that man get raped and she belongs to somebody, that woman's supposed to scream out, you know?
Yeah, we're supposed to put evil away from Israel.
A lot of these bitches are like, oh man, you know, that's everybody around.
Let me just go and take care of this man real quick. What church are you from? This is church right here. We in church. This is church right here. No, we're Hebrew Israelites. Hebrew Israelites, right. Are you Native American or something? Yes, mixed. Okay, what's your father? My mother's side. Okay, you're what your father is. Here we go. You're what your father is. What's that right here? You like the poems? Yeah, I like poems. Yes.
Oh, thank you.
Just keep in mind that God loves you. I had cancer, and through prayer, Jesus completely healed me.
Oh, wow.
Okay, you know, there's a secret to killing cancer. Cancer can't live in a body that's alkaline, that's acidic. I mean, that's alkaline based.
Jesus is the answer for everything.
Hey, listen to me, though. I'm trying to get a physician to you.
I don't want to miss my bus.
Okay.
Just know that Jesus is the only answer.
Yeah.
Hey, I got a scripture. Anybody read something?
It's a simple thing. The way to kill it is to die. That's the thing.
Yeah, to die.
It's the same. It's just like dying.
Yeah, that was spinning.
Well, here goes
right here is the main diet. Yeah, because I don't think the Lord's gonna want to heal you if he eats one. Oh, you know that's madness. Oh, that's what it is. Revelation 21:6, and he said unto me, "It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death." Now the first death was the flood, right? The second death is death by fire. When you read about fire and brimstone in the Bible, it's not talking about hell. There ain't no such thing as hell, all right? That's Norse mythology, okay? Fire and brimstone is when the Lord's gonna rain fire and he's gonna destroy America with fire. And those missiles start dropping out of the sky. That's fire and brimstone.
Isaiah 54:16. Behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, and that bringeth forth an instrument for his work, and I have created the waster to destroy.
So the modern day blacksmith is that rocket scientist. The Lord created the rocket scientists. The Lord is the one who gave those rocket scientists that technology so they can bring forth the work of the Lord, which is the missiles, which is the destruction, which is the mushroom clouds, the total nuclear holocaust, total death and destruction, and that's what's coming.
Okay, I feel
like I've been wanting to see that for a minute.
I watched it about 10 times.
Oh, yeah? Thread.
It's the baddest nuclear movie there is.
I got
the movie. Everybody's just minding their business. And all through the movie, the beginning before the news hit, everybody's hearing the news. Everybody's at the supermarket. They're seeing the TVs with Russia and Iran. It mentions Russia, it mentions Iran, it mentions Israel, it mentions the U.S. They're hearing all the conflict, but everybody's shopping. Everybody preparing to get married. You know, everybody's not paying attention until the missiles drop. There's very few people that was like, "Oh man, we gotta prepare, we gotta do something." You know, it was very few people. And as a matter of fact, now I mentioned, I think it was only like two or three people that was actually prepared until the missiles hit. It was too late then. Nobody was taking that warning. It was, it ain't gonna happen.
But the missiles are coming.
Yeah, they coming.
If you ain't praying to Yahweh Bosh, send me a house shy to forgive you of your wickedness. Hey, you gonna eat missiles.
Yeah, you don't wanna be here when that shaking starts.
Nah. The earth is gonna reel to and fro like a drunkard. The earth is gonna wobble.
Isaiah 13.
I got that scripture too.
Yeah, bring that one out.
This is Isaiah 24:18. And it shall come to pass that he that fleeth from the noise of the fear shall fall into the pit, and he that cometh up out of the midst of the pit shall be taken in their snare. For the windows from on high are open, and the foundations of the earth do shake. The earth is utterly broken down. The earth is clean dissolved. The earth is moved exceedingly.
So when those missiles start raining out of the sky, those missiles are coming.
Okay.
If y'all don't know what an ICBM is, you better Google it. Because those missiles are going to start dropping out of the sky. White, because they're coming straight from the USSR.
Independent, they call some of them MIRVs.
Oh,
multiple
yeah.
Independently re-entry vehicles. Jeez.
Don't ever forget about the missiles. Because they are on their way. You know what I mean?
Yes, they are. The earth shall reel to and fro like a drunkard, and shall be removed like a cottage. And the transgressions thereof shall be heavy upon it, and it shall fall and not rise again.
Yeah, so when America's destroyed, there ain't gonna be no more America. They going to be no, oh, it's gonna rise as a phoenix out of ashes. Nope. It's gonna be ashes. It's gonna stay ashes.
What is the phoenix? Is that part of Greek mythology?
Or? That's where you get the word Phoenician. It's some Canaanite shit, okay. Really. When you really, I mean, it's Greek mythology, but they say it comes from the Canaanites.
Right, not even a real fucking bird, but they clean that shit like
right,
a
yeah.
A phoenix. Look at that as well.
It's a Hamite bird.
Right.
It really is.
What's the girl, the X-Men that turned into the Phoenix?
Oh, the Jean Grey?
Yeah.
That's some bad shit right there. Yeah. I already know what that is.
She defeats Darkseid. No, she defeats Westeros.
Yeah, Darkseid. That's the Apocalypse.
Apocalypse, right. Same thing, huh?
Yeah, pretty much the same thing. I like both of them. Hey, what you got? Because I don't read this, what you got? You sure?
Yeah.
You act like you got something real long. This is long too though. 2 Ezra 16:1. Woe be unto thee, Babylon and Asia. Woe be unto thee, Egypt and Syria. Gird up yourselves with cloths of sack. That's what we wearing, right? Even though this is talking to these other countries. Because we're in mourning, a state of mourning. But the heathens, they gonna be mourning too.
They about to get it.
Gird up your, you know the word sack too, the Hebrew word. Sack is spelled S-H-Q in Hebrew, like shack, shack, shock. Like shack, also almost like spelled that. But the word sack, you know, it's a Hebrew word. We speak Hebrew every day. Gird up yourselves with cloths of sack and hair. Bewail your children and be sorry, for your destruction is at hand. A sword is sent upon you, and who may turn it back? So when those missiles start coming out of the sky, you're gonna be like, please missiles, turn around. Nah, once the missiles is going, they going. There ain't no stopping the missiles. Right. Look, a fire is sent among you, and who may quench it? Plagues are sent unto you, and what is he that may drive them away? May any man drive away a hungry lion in the wood, or may anyone quench the fire in stubble when it hath begun to burn? May one turn again the arrow that is shot of a strong archer? Now the modern day arrows, those missiles, and that strong archer is that missile silo. Okay? The mighty Lord sendeth the plagues, and who is he that can drive them away? A fire shall go forth from his wrath, and who is he that may quench it? He shall cast lightnings, and who shall not fear? He shall thunder, and who shall not be afraid? Look, check this out. The Lord, and they talk about you making threats, you're making threats. The Lord shall threaten, and who shall not be utterly beaten to powder at his presence? The earth quaketh in the foundations thereof. The sea arises up with waves from the deep, and the waves of it are troubled, and the fishes thereof also before the Lord, before the power, the glory of his power.
I guarantee I-U-I-C-K, word from
never read that.
Read that.
Hell no.
That's
a threat to their existence.
Right, they ain't prophesying for this world again.
No, that's the prophecy. Because like you see that too, it said the earth's going to quake, and even the waves. Because when the missiles hit, that's going to cause tsunamis too.
It's going to be a shift, the earth shifting.
Like you said,
tectonic plates going to shift.
Bring that, like you said, that flood with the house burning on the river, you're going to say a whole damn country burning.
That's the lake of fire.
It's gonna be beautiful. Let me rest it. There's more to it though.
Literally, that's literal lake of fire.
Yeah, that's a literal lake of fire. I see you swimming that. Do a breaststroke through it.
Yeah. to see what men and girls can do in that survival situation.
Oh, yeah. For strong, this is 2 Ezra 16 and 13. For strong is his right hand that bendeth the bow. His arrows that he shooteth are sharp and shall not miss when they begun to be shot into the ends of the world. So how do you shoot an arrow to the end of the world? That's talking about a missile. That's them ICBM. ICBM stands for Intercontinental Ballistic Missile. It goes from continent to continent.
Don't Russia got something that goes 7, 8 miles?
Yeah, they can just go around the whole earth and come down on your ass. They shoot a missile up in the outer space, miles and miles, and come right, drop it right on your ass.
Shoot one missile, but multiple ones come from that one.
Yeah, for that one missile. That's beautiful.
Multiple Satan tubes.
I gotta get the rest of it. I'm almost done. It's so good.
There's so much. This is meat of it.
Behold, the plagues are sent and shall not return again until they come upon the earth. The fire is kindled and shall not be put out till it consume the foundation of the earth. Like as an arc, like as an arrow which is shot of a mighty archer returneth not backwards, even so the plagues that shall be sent upon the earth shall not return again. Woe is me, woe is me, who will deliver me in those days? The beginning of sorrows and great mournings, the beginning of famine and great death, the beginning of wars, and the powers shall stand in fear, the beginning of evils. What shall I do when these evils shall come? Behold, famine and plague, tribulation and anguish are sent as scourges for amendment. But for all these things, they shall not turn from their wickedness, nor be always mindful of the scourges. See, because even when the famines break out, they're going to shut off EBT. They ain't going to be no more EBT. One day, you're going to go to the store, there ain't going to be no food. And then you're going to have riots, then you're going to have cannibalism. Then come the diseases, all right? And then they still ain't gonna turn away from the wickedness. That's when the Lord gonna hit y'all with a missile.
Crazy. Because
that's how wicked Israel is. You know what I mean?
They're hoping the trauma passes so they can continue on, you know?
Yep.
Hoping they can withstand
like
the
storm. Like it's almost over.
Yep.
As soon as this is done, I'm gonna
right back to my seat.
Yep.
Back to my clique, my street, you know, see my boys there, you know, my boys.
No, he got eaten.
Right. They depend on that shit too, man, their boys. The least dependent person they can depend on is
I seen somebody post something today warning about the coming famine and stuff. And somebody covered himself in blood and wrapped himself up inside of a food packet. And it said something about carne, meat, human meat. You seen that?
Yeah.
Well, it was retarded, but that's really what's going to be. This thing, when that famine hits, you going to trump, because money's going to be worthless, but you'll be trading. You'll be like, I got this, you ain't got the leg of lamb, I got a leg of some hoe. You know what I mean? I got this leg meat right here. I'll give you this leg meat for that gasoline. They say that in Korea, North Korea, I don't know if it's true. Because you know they like to lie about North Korea. Yeah, but they try to say this. The food is scarce up there, so they're selling human meat on the black market. Or just in the regular market. But you can see that happening out here.
I mean, it's happening in Venezuela, I'm sure.
Oh, you know they eat people in Venezuela right now. But they said they ran out of dogs and cats to eat. Now they're trying to catch pigeons.
This is wicked, man. I'm not dismissing cannibalism.
It's in the scripture.
That's a Latin tribe. They known for that.
Oh, they probably do it before the famine.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
They're doing their witchcraft, their rituals, and whatever madness they do.
Yeah.
The islands is full of that madness, man.
Oh, let me get just a quick precept.
I gotta go too.
I keep dying to get that scripture.
You got all of them. Hey. Well, this is our one.
Oh, yeah. I'm taking forever to get
to. That's a preset. I mean, I know other cans would be like, nah, bro, you don't need one. This man is giving an inspirational speech from his heart.
All right.
You know what I'm saying?
All right. So, Jeremiah 19:7. And I will make void the council of Judah and Jerusalem in this place. Yeah, the hell with all these wicked-ass Israelites just talking about. We ain't trying to hear your words. And I will cause them to fall by the sword before their enemies and by the hands of them that seek their lives. And their carcass will I give to be meat for the fowls of the heaven and for the beasts of the earth. And I will make this city desolate, a hissing. Everyone that passeth thereby shall be astonished and hissed because of all the plagues thereof.
This city.
And I will cause them to eat the flesh of their sons and the flesh of their daughters, and they shall eat everyone the flesh of his friend.
That's a famine that's coming, y'all.
In the siege and straitness, where if their enemies and they that seek their lives shall straighten them. Yeah, because when that famine comes, there's going to be cannibalism out here.
Do we need to explain what a famine is?
Maybe y'all figure it out. You'll figure it out.
Right. There's a famine coming. Two famines. One of truth and one of bread. Yep. You know? It's coming.
You'll see. Don't worry.
You want to get that man. You want to go
yeah,
over
let
here,
me get
man.
A scripture.
You know, you getting itchy over here.
Hey, you know how it be. It's a lot of good.
Isaiah 13 and I'm sorry, 6. They come from a far country, from the end of heaven, even from Yahweh, and the weapons of his indignation to destroy the whole land. How ye, for the day of Yahweh is at hand. It shall come as a destruction from the Almighty. Therefore shall all hands be faint, and every man's heart shall melt, and they shall be afraid. Pains and sorrow shall take hold of them. They shall be amazed as a woman that travaileth. They shall be amazed, every one at another. Their faces shall be as flames. Behold, the day of Yahweh cometh, cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger.
Yeah, so the Bible says the day of the Lord is cruel, okay? The Lord is the one who's about to bring all this evil on the earth, okay?
Too late.
Now, if you know people, oh, God is all love. Somebody's gonna pop out and say it.
That ain't my Jesus. That's some funny shit. It never fail. They faking it though.
How many times you gotta hear it?
Yeah. They faking it though.
Yeah, y'all say God is all love when
they done played it out.
When your leg done got sawed off and they preserving the rest of your body in the meat locker.
Right, hold on, bro. Let me read this quick precept. Isaiah 45:7. I form the light and create darkness. I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, do all these things.
And so it's the Lord that creates evil, and the Lord who creates good, and love, and hate. He created everything, the whole entire universe, and every dimension, and every everything.
Right, that distant star that the telescopes can't reach.
Exactly.
That shit is so distant, man. Your mind can't fathom the distance. That's just showing what Israel will be doing, man.
Oh, yeah, you know? Hey, so, yeah, right.
That's just showing what Israel will
be. I should put that on camera.
I'm
going to get it on this one, too. Because that's what y'all going to be doing. When all the food's gone, y'all going to be just like these birds.
See how the birds are
stabbing
you?
Oh, shit.
God knows what they eat.
As soon as I zoomed in, my shit died.
Damn.